In World of Tanks, both teams are represented by 15 players. One player generally stands out as the ace tanker. This is their story. Hey tankers, Bonsai Duck here. Today we have middle-aged noob from the 27 Car Clan. He's in his AMX-12T. He is on Stadinsky in a standard battle in a tier 6 game. So, middle-aged noob, French auto-loading light. What does that mean? Well, that means generally it doesn't work out well for the other team. Anyway, middle-aged spawned on the west side, and he looks to be headed, we'll go south. And middle-aged, take it away. Alright. Got T-50-2 running through the middle. AMD 178 Bravo meeting him in the ditch. Who's going to win that battle? Looks like the AMD did. Alright. Combat fly, T-50-2. He is down. Middle Age comes screaming over here. Now, are there bushes over here that are worth a crap? I've just never really taken the time to find out. I suppose if you have a really good team, a really good crew, and a nice French auto-loading light, you can make it work. Ouch! You guys just... What? You are all by yourself, buddy. All by yourself. That is a scary proposition. Scary. Oh, there he comes. Rhino Boy. It is Type 64. We also got a VK-2801. Your VK-3002 is just... Oh, now we've got an EZ-8 coming in here. Jesus. Your team has just given this side up, apparently. Decided, no, we don't want to push in that hard. We don't want to play that hard today. Okay? We don't want to do it. I don't know where the Type 64 is running off to. EZ-8. Nice. Dude. He's not okay. He's just blind firing. Okay, now I think he has an idea. He's starting to follow the tracer. Artie's in on him twice. Ouch. VK-3002 has decided to move up. You have the binos on. You don't look like you're running. I'm sure you've told me what your equipment is, but I'm guessing it's probably the exhaust, because then you're not running a camo net. EZ-8 just got chewed up. Just absolutely chewed up. Oh, what do we got back there? Oh, TOG. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a TOG on the field. Alert, there is a TOG on the field. All right. TOG backing up. Well, your heavies, which consists of two TOGs, are holding their own over there. You got Super Chaffee holding the A line. So the demarcation line, 5 and 6, seem to be holding their own. Oh, there's the TOG. TOG. Oh, ricochet. There's a one right into the soft skin. There's another one into the superstructure. Oh, got a critical out of that one. And now we're on a reload. And he's just sitting there. Just sitting there. Just sitting there. Gonna let you shoot him. Here comes Mr. T's Type 64. Oh, missed that one. Oh, clips him. TOG sees you. Yeah. here comes Artie. Oh, yeah, looking through your scope, and all of a sudden, there you are, looking straight down the barrel of a TOG. Oh, and Type 64 is pushing hard. Yeah, he's like, he's going to chase you out of there. All right, you're reloading. Rhino Boys 22. There's one. Oh, come on. Get that third one. And you kill him with the last shot. And he's driving away. Nicely done. The accuracy on this tank is not that incredible. All right. Well, now we just have the TOG 2 over by himself. Here comes the T-50-2. Nice of you to join the game, buddy. TOG, he knows he's caught out. He knows he is. Yep, dead. On the reload. It's nice of that T-50-2 to help you out. I'm going to sit back here until you guys clear the flank, and then I'm going to come up there and take over, okay? He's obviously on an arty hunt. Must have an arty mission. Light arty mission. You must kill all the arty in the game. Damn, he beat you to it. But he's taking some punishment for it. We are down to 12 rounds left, and there are still some major hit points on the table. I think you're going to have to start being conservative here, middle age. Taking some wise shots. T-50-2 on their side is taking on your Hellcat. Which was not a good thing for him. The TOG got him. Oh, AT-8. He fires and misses. Oh. And there's another shot and misses. He gets that one. Now he's opened his sight up to you. He really wants to get a shot onto you. And there's another one. Oh, there's Artie. And the AT-8 is down. Their VK-3601H is moving in. Yeah, up. He's hiding. He's hiding. He knows the finish is coming. He's like, guys, help. I'm sure he's screaming, that dang Artie. Useless Artie. You gotta love it. Gotta love it. There's still a Hellcat around here somewhere, so be cautious. And he hasn't been spotted yet? No, he's not been spotted yet. Wonder where the Hellcat went. TOG moving in on the VK-3601. Oh, what do we have here? There he is. He hid back there the whole time. And then there's Artie. And he's down. One more Artie to go. Kaboom, kaboom, and he's down. And that is the victory. All right, well, you got an ace tanker out of that, spotter, bruiser, fire for effect, 100,019 in credits, 4,030 in experience, and 30 bonds. You did 2,056 in damage, got 2 kills for base XP of 1,343. Nice work. I mean, look at that. You just absolutely kicked ass in the base XP. 30 shots were fired. Of those, 21 hit, and of those, 16 penetrated. 1,400 from 300 meters out, and you assisted with 2,285. Oh, man. For a total combined, yeah, I mean, 4K combined, yep, that'll work. Good credits, good experience. Just a classic spotting game. Getting out there in the middle and keeping them lit. You know, unfortunately, the Type 64 came back and chased you out of there for a little bit, but you were able to return the favor and put him out of your misery. And then, of course, just sit there and chew up the TOG, which allowed you to push through. So, I mean, just a good classic game, especially on a flank where you had almost zero to no support. So, had they pushed in hard, I think that would have been a different game, but they chose to be a little bit cautious. So, anyway, that is middle-aged noob from the 27 Car Clan and his AMX-12T on Stadinsky in a standard battle. If you like the video, hit the like button. Keep those videos coming, I greatly appreciate it. Please remember to hit the subscribe button. This is Banzai Duck out.